All right, Doc Positive here at the Paws Veterinary Clinic, and we're here with Anton. Anton is cute as can be. He's an interesting breed. He's a breed Doc has never seen before, called a Swedish Valhund. You know, if Doc didn't know better, he looks almost like a Norwegian Elkhound with a Basset body. But these are dogs who were bred over in Scandinavia for doing search and rescue work. He's the only one Doc's ever seen. But he's in today because he's been having trouble moving his bowels, having trouble defecating. And because he's an unusual breed, he was never neutered. The breeder intended to use him in a breeding program. He never was, but because he was never neutered, he has actually developed here benign prostate hyperplasia. This picture shows, this is the dog's colon, bladder, and prostate gland. In older male dogs who aren't neutered, the prostate gland is under testosterone influence. And that prostate gland will swell and swell and swell. And you can see there, it pinches off their colon. So he's been straining to have a bowel movement. That's the primary problem, but it has caused a secondary problem. Mom had noticed he's got a large bulge here. I don't know if you can really appreciate that because of the hair coat he has. But over here on this side of the right side of his rectum, he's got a huge bulge. And when Dr. Claire, that's me, did a rectal exam, we can't even get our finger in there. That's why he's straining to defecate, because he actually now has a perineal hernia. P-E-R-I-N-E-A-L. Perineal. Not perianal, but it's kind of the same. Perianal. Perianal would be next to his anus. Perineal, because with his prostate hyperplasia and straining to defecate, here we have a picture of perineal anatomy. He can be down, Lisa, we can put him down. But he's been straining to defecate, and what he's done is he's torn from straining. He's herniated these muscles alongside of his rectum and his anus. And now he has intestinal and colon contents that are pushed out in there. So I discussed with Mom. He's in great health. These guys do tend to have long lives, and so I am referring Mom to a friend of mine who is a veterinary surgeon, board-certified surgeon down in Lehigh Valley, who does more advanced, more complicated surgeries. Because with this, I told Mom, I said, I can fix it. I don't recommend me. Don't have a lot of experience with perineal hernias. And with this, if you want to go with a surgeon who's got a great deal of experience, we're going to send her to a board-certified surgeon, and we will recommend that he be neutered at the same time. Because if we don't neuter him, neutering will allow his prostate gland to shrink down to a more normal size. Then when he shrinks the prostate, he'll be able to have bowel movements more normally, and he won't be likely to re-injure that hernia. In the meantime, he is on stool softeners and laxatives to try and help him pass the stool. But Anton is going to go see a surgeon to repair the perineal hernia and to get him neutered to shrink down his benign prostate hyperplasia. Bye now.